Hi everyone, it's Bianca here. Welcome to a new tutorial. Today I will show you how to crochet this beautiful big 3D flower square. What do we need for this square? 5 different colors of yarn. I'm using leftover yarn from Scheepjes, stone washed, and this one is a river washed color. The crochet hook that I'm using is a 3.5 mm. You need also a scissors and a needle. First color for me is that a light blue, and with the first color we create a magic circle on the hook. And we make in the magic circle popcorn stitches. And your first popcorn stitch is a little bit different than the other popcorn stitches. The first popcorn stitch, make a chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. This chain 3 counts for your first double crochet. Now here in the magic circle, make 4 more double crochets. So yarn over, enter hook in the magic circle, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. That's 1. Yarn over, back in that same circle, make a double crochet. That's 2. Three and 4. We have here with your first chain 3, 5 double crochets. Now make a little loop and then go out with your hook and go to the first double crochet. That's the chain 3. Then in the third chain stitch, you go in with your hook on the top here. Then the loop goes back on your hook. Pull to close and then pull through that first double crochet. And this is your first popcorn stitch. Now make a chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. In the magic circle, you make a new popcorn stitch. We begin with 5 double crochets in that circle. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we have to close the popcorn stitch. You make a little loop, go out your hook. Then on top of the first double crochet of that 5, you go here under through that V. Then the loop goes back on the hook. Close that loop and then pull that loop through that first double crochet and then make a chain 3. And this popcorn stitch and that chain 3 we have to repeat 4 more times. I'll show you once more. For a third popcorn stitch, you work 5 double crochets in the magic circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Make a little loop, go out of your work, back to the top of the first double crochet of the group of 5, under through that V on the top. The loop goes back on the hook. Close and pull through that first stitch and then make a chain 3. Repeat that popcorn stitch and that chain 3 3 more times. I'm all the way around, 6 popcorn stitches in total with between a chain 3. Also after that last 6th popcorn stitch you have to work that chain 3. Close on the top of the first popcorn stitch with a slip stitch. go in here, in the middle, you work in the back of that stitch, make a slip stitch, yarn over, pull through and pull through, and cut the yarn. And now we have to close that magic circle. Pull on the short till you're in the middle, so the ring is closed like this. Now wave the tail in on the back of the stitches, make first a little knot, also that little tail that you cut off here. The second color, for me is that a darker blue. Make a slip knot on the hook. And we start with our first popcorn stitch in a chain 3 space. It doesn't matter which one, you choose one. And your first popcorn stitch is 5 double crochets. And your first double crochet is a standing double crochet. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in that chain 3. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over and pull through 2. This is your first double crochet of 5. Make 4 more double crochets in that same space. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have to close that popcorn stitch, make a little loop, go with your hook on the top of the first double crochet, that standing double crochet, under through that V. Then grab your working tail, the loop goes back on the hook, close that stitch and pull through that first stitch. Make a chain 3. Now here back in that same chain 3 space, make another popcorn stitch. 5 double crochets in that space. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Make a little loop. On top of the first double crochet, you go under through that V on the top, grab that loop, pull through, and make a chain 3. And all these stitches, we repeat these 5 more times. I'll show you the next repeat. We skip over the next popcorn stitch, and then here, in the next chain 3 space, we make 2 popcorn stitches with between a chain 3 and after that second top popcorn stitch, also a chain 3. The first popcorn stitch, 5 double crochets in the next chain 3 space. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, close the popcorn, make a chain 3, back in that same space with another popcorn stitch, 5 double crochets in that space, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Close the popcorn, and make a chain 3. This is the way how you work all the way around. Repeat those stitches 4 more times. I'm all the way around. I am made here 12 popcorn stitches in total with between a chain 3. After that last popcorn stitch, you have to work also that chain 3, for we close with a slip stitch on the top of the first popcorn stitch. Here on the back of the popcorn stitch, you go in the back, grab your yarn, pull through, and then pull through. Cut the yarn and weave both tails in. Round 3, new colors on the hook. For me is that the river wash color, that light blue brown green color. And we begin with a standing single crochet. And the place where we start is in the loop of the chain 3 space after the 2 popcorn stitches that we work in the same chain 3 space of the previous round. Then that chain 3 after those 2 popcorn stitches, standing single crochet. The yarn is on the hook, enter the hook in the chain 3, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull for 2. Now in the next chain 3 space we make a shell. 7 double crochets in the next space, yarn over, you skip that popcorn stitch, enter the hook in the next chain 3 space, that's 1, 7 in total, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 double crochets, and all these stitches we repeat all the way around. So we skip over the next popcorn stitch into the next chain 3 space, make 1 single crochet, skip over the next popcorn stitch in the next chain 3 space, make a new shell of 7 double crochets all in that same space. It's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Work like this all the way around. I worked all my stitches all the way around. We have now 6 shells in total. We close with a slip stitch on top of the first standing single crochet. Enter your hook, grab your yarn, pull through, pull through. Cut the yarn, weave both tails in. I made a slip knot on the hook with a light green color. And we begin with a standing popcorn stitch, where we make that single crochet in that chain 3. We work again in that same chain 3 over that single crochet with a first standing double crochet for to create a popcorn stitch of 5 double crochets in total. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over. Enter your hook in that chain 3 space of round 2, grab your yarn and pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2 for your first standing double crochet, and you work over that single crochet. In that same space make 4 more double crochets. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have to close that popcorn stitch, make a loop on top of the first standing double crochet, loop goes back on the hook and pull through. Now you have to work one chain stitch to close the popcorn stitch. Around the shell, the first shell here, that 7 double crochets, we work a back post single crochet around each stitch. Go from behind around that first double crochet, then from the front to the back, grab your yarn, pull under through, two loops on the hook, yarn over and pull for two. Around the next stitch, from behind, from the back to the front, around the second double crochet, from the front to the back, grab your yarn, pull under through, two loops on the hook, yarn over and work that single crochet. And now you see here on the front that little stitch. Around the next stitch, back post single crochet. That's three. Around the next stitch, four. Around the next, five, six, and seven. You see here these little stitches on the front, and you work those single crochets on the back of your work. All these stitches we repeat 5 more times. I'll show you the repeat once more. Here that single crochet that we work in round 2 in that chain 3 space. In that same space we make another popcorn stitch of 5 double crochets. Work 5 double crochets in that chain 3 space and work around that single crochet. One, two, three, four, and 5 double crochets. Then on top of the first double crochet, you go in with your hook, place the loop back on the hook, and then pull through and make one chain to close the popcorn. Then the next shell, 7 back post single crochets around the first double crochet here. Go around that stitch, then on the back make that single crochet. That's the first of 7. It's 1, around the next stitch, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and number 7. Repeat those stitches 4 more times. Then here on the top of the first popcorn stitch, you work in the back of that stitch. Here you work that slip stitch. Then cut the yarn and wave both tails in. Next colors on the hook with the slip knot. Light yellow for me. And we begin in the stitch after the popcorn stitch in the first back post single crochet. In that stitch we work our first 2 double crochet together, a standing 2 double crochet together. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in the first back post single crochet, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull for 2. You make that double crochet not complete. You have here 2 stitches left over on the hook. Yarn over, go back into that same stitch for second time, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull for two. Now you have three loops on the hook. These two loops is for the two not complete double crochets and your slip knot here on the hook. Yarn over and pull through all the loops in one go. Make a chain two, one and two. Go back into that same stitch and make another two double crochet together. Yarn over in that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through two. Yarn over, back into that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through two. Also three loops on the hook. We work those loops together. Yarn over and pull through three in one go. This is a V-stitch of two double crochet together, chain two, two double crochet together. Now skip the next two stitches, one and two, and then into the next stitch, we work again a V-stitch at the same way that we did here. Two double crochet together, pull yarn over, skip the next two stitches into the next stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, back in that same stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two. Work those two double crochets together and make a chain two. Back in that same stitch with another two double crochet together. That's one, back in that same stitch. And two, work those stitches together. Skip the next two stitches into the next stitch, and that's the stitch for the next popcorn. We work also again a V-stitch of two double crochet together, chain two, two double crochet together. So yarn over, skip the next two stitches, two double crochet together into the next stitch, chain two, two double crochet together back in that same stitch. So one and two and work together. Make a chain one. And all these stitches is the repeat you work all the way around. So yarn over. Then after that popcorn stitch into the first back post single crochet. We work a new V-stitch of two double crochet together, chain two, two double crochet together, back in that same stitch, yarn over, skip the next two stitches, into the next stitch, make one more V-stitch of two double crochet together, chain two, two double crochet together, back in that same stitch, yarn over, skip the next two stitches, into the next stitch, make a V-stitch of two double crochet together, chain two, two double crochet together, back in that same stitch, and then we have to work one chain to skip over the next popcorn stitch. This is the way how you work all the way around. Close with a slip stitch on the top of the first standing two double crochet together, cut the yarn and weave both tails in. I made a slip knot on the hook with the first light blue color. And we work all the way around popcorn stitches with between a chain three. In every space between the two groups of two double crochets together, in that chain two space we work a popcorn stitch, then a chain three, and also in that space here between the two groups of the V stitches, in that space here, also a popcorn stitch with five double crochets. And then after that popcorn, you work a chain three. Your first popcorn stitch is a standing popcorn stitch of 5 double crochets. The first is a standing double crochet. Yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in the chain 2 space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2 for your first double crochet. 4 more double crochets in that same space. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So you have 5 double crochets in that same space. Close the popcorn on top of the first double crochet. And then make a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Then skip over the 2 double crochets together here of the V-stitch, and then between the 2 double crochets together, also in that space here, you work also 5 double crochets to create the next popcorn stitch. That's 2, 3, 4, and 5. Close the popcorn, make a chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and all these stitches we repeat all the way around. Here in the next chain 2 space also popcorn stitch, after the popcorn a chain 3, and also in that space here between the 2 V stitches also a popcorn stitch, then a chain 3 all the way around. If you work all the way around all your popcorn stitches, then you have on the end of this round 36 popcorn stitches. When you're all the way around, then close with a slip stitch on top here of the first popcorn stitch, here in the back of that stitch, with a slip stitch, cut the yarn and weave both tails in. The darker blue is back on the hook, and we make all the way around in every chain 3 space a new popcorn stitch and then a chain 3. At the same way that we did on the previous round. The first is a standing popcorn stitch, also this popcorn 5 double crochets in total. Close the popcorn and make a chain 3. All these stitches we repeat all the way around. So you skip the next popcorn stitch, in the next chain 3 space a new popcorn stitch of 5 double crochets. Close the popcorn, and after the popcorn make a chain 3 all the way around. Close also with a slip stitch here on the top in the back of the first popcorn stitch and weave the tails in. The third color is back on the hook. And we start with a standing single crochet. And the place where we start, here's a shell of the same color. And above that shell, here, you'll see that V-stitch. In that V-stitch we work 1 popcorn stitch. And then above that popcorn stitch in that chain 3 space. That's the place where we start, with a standing single crochet. Where's my yarn? There. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and put for two for a standing single crochet. Skip over the popcorn stitch and then into the next chain 3 space make a shell of 5 double crochets all in that same space. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And these 6 stitches is the repeat you work all the way around. I'll show you once more the repeat. We skip over the next popcorn stitch. In the next chain 3 space, make 1 single crochet. Skip over the next popcorn. And then in the next chain 3 space, make 5 double crochets in that space. That's 1. And 2. 3. 4 and 5. Work like this all the way around. Then close with a slip stitch on the top of the first standing single crochet, cut the yarn and weave the tails in. Color light green is back on my hook and we start with a popcorn stitch, a standing popcorn stitch between the two popcorn stitches where we make in the previous round that single crochet. In that space between the two popcorn stitches and we work around that single crochet here. First standing popcorn stitch, standing double crochet with 4 double crochets in that same space. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5 double crochets to create a popcorn. Close the popcorn stitch on top of the first standing double crochet. Then make 1 chain to close. And now around those 5 double crochets of that shell here, we make back post half double crochets around each stitch 1. Yarn over. Enter hook from behind for that first double crochet, go around the double crochet, then on the back you grab your yarn and pull up 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through 3 in 1 go. See here on the front that little stitch. Also around the next 4 stitches, yarn over, enter your hook from behind. Go around that second double crochet, from the front to the back, grab your yarn, pull on the 2, yarn over and pull through 3. That's 2, around the next stitch, that's 3, around the next stitch, 4 and around the next stitch, 5. And these stitches, this is the repeat we work all the way around. I'll show you the repeat once more. Between the next 2 popcorn stitches in that chain 3 space where we make also that single crochet, make a new popcorn stitch in that space and work around that single crochet here. 5 double crochets in that space. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 double crochets. Back to the first double crochet to close the popcorn and then a chain. Around the next 5 double crochets, make 1 half double crochet around each stitch. Back post half double crochet. That's 2, 3, 4, 5. Work like this all the way around, close with a slip stitch in the top here, in the back of that popcorn stitch, and weave the tails in. We're done with the popcorn flower. Now we have to work on our square, and I place the yellow color back on the hook. And the place where we start, here that green popcorn stitch, then you go up to the side here, and then this green popcorn stitch here, and then one stitch after that popcorn. That's in the first back post half double crochet of the shell after that popcorn stitch. You go in at your hook and make a standing single crochet. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull for 2. And this standing single crochet is the first single crochet of 10 in total. Into the next 9 stitches, also 1 single crochet. This is 1, 10 in total. In the next stitch, 2, 3, 4, and 5, number 6 here, for the popcorn. Now we skip here that chain. That chain that counts for nothing, that's only to close that popcorn. So in the next stitch is the first back post half double crochet of the next shell. That's 7, 8, 9, and 10. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now we skip the next stitch, and then in the next stitch, that's here for the popcorn, we make a V-stitch at the same way that we did here with the yellow color. Of 2 double crochets together, so yarn over, skip the next stitch, and here for the popcorn, we make 2 double crochets together. That's 1 and 2. Yarn over, work together, make a chain 2, back into that same stitch with another 2 double crochet together. For your first V stitch. Now skip the next 2 stitches. That chain counts for nothing. It's 1 and 2, and then in the third stitch, that's on the third back post half double crochet of the next shell, we make another V stitch of 2 double crochet together in that stitch. Yarn over, work together, make a chain 2, then 2 double crochet together back in that same stitch. So here after that single crochet we skip 1 stitch. Then after the V-stitch we skipped 2 stitches, and now after that next V-stitch we skip 3 stitches. So 1, 2 and then 3. We skip that chain also, counts for nothing. So we make here in the next stitch, and that's on top of the first back post half double crochet of the next shell, we make a corner of 2 trebles together. Yarn twice over the hook, then here on top of the first back post half double crochet of the next shell, go in with your hook in that stitch, grab your yarn and pull up. Now you have four loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. You make that treble knot complete. You have here two loops on the hook. Yarn twice over the hook, go back into that same stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. Now we have here two knot complete trebles on the hook. We work all these stitches together, yarn over and pull through three in one go. Make a chain two, one and two, then go back in that same stitch with another two trebles together, yarn over twice, back in that same stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over twice, back into that same stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, three loops on the hook, work together, yarn over, pull through three loops in one go. Make a chain two, and again we make two more trebles together in that same stitch, yarn over twice, back in that same stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over twice, back in that same stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, work together, yarn over, work through three loops in one go. After that corner, we skip three stitches, one, two, three, then in the next stitch, that's on top of the fifth back post half double crochet, we make a new V stitch of two double crochet together. It's one, two, yarn over, work together, chain two, and back in that same stitch with two double crochet together. After that corner we skip three stitches, and now we have to skip two stitches. The first is here for the popcorn. The chain counts for nothing. The second is here the first back post half double crochet. Then in the next back post half double crochet, the second one, we make also a V stitch of two double crochet together. It's one and two, work together, make the chain two, two double crochet together, back in that same stitch. It's one and two, yarn over, work together. Now we have to skip one stitch. Then in the next stitch, make one single crochet. And this single crochet is the same single crochet than here in the beginning. So we have to work 11 single crochets on this side here. We made one already. In the next stitch, it's two. In the next stitch for the popcorn, it's number three. We skip the chain, counts for nothing. Number four is on the top of the first back post half double crochet of the next shell. Then five, six, seven, eight. Number nine is for the popcorn. And then number 10 is here in the first back post half double crochet of the next shell. Now we repeat all these V stitches and the corner. We skip one stitch. Then in the next stitch, make a V stitch of two double crochet together. Chain two. Two double crochet together, back in that same stitch. Yarn over, work together. Here for that first V stitch, we skip one stitch. Then after that V stitch, we skip two stitches. One, two, into the next stitch, that's here for the popcorn. You make a new V stitch of two double crochet together. Chain two, two double crochet together in that same stitch. Here we skip one stitch, Then we skip 2 stitches, now we skip 3 stitches. That chain counts for nothing. So 1, 2, 3 stitches, we skip those stitches, and then in the 4th one, and that's the 4th back post half double crochet of the next shell. We make a new corner. 2 trebles together. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. In that stitch here. So I count right. It's 1, 2, 3. Oh my gosh, that's not good. We yarn twice over. It's 1, 2, 3 in that stitch. That 4th back post half double crochet. 2 trebles together. It's 1. Back in that same stitch. 2. Yarn over, work together. Make a chain 2. Back in that same stitch with another 2 trebles together. That's 1. And 2, work together, make a chain 2. And again, back in that same stitch with another 2 trebles together. To complete the second corner. We skip 3 stitches, 1, 2, and 3, then in the 4th stitch, that's the 2nd back post half double crochet of the next shell, we make a V-stitch of 2 double crochet together in that stitch, chain 2, 2 double crochet together back in that same stitch. So here after that corner we skip 3 stitches. Then after that V-stitch, we skip 2 stitches, 1 and 2. In the next stitch, we make a new V-stitch of 2 double crochet together. Chain 2. 2 double crochet together back in that same stitch. And then we have to skip 1 stitch. And that's the stitch here for the popcorn. That chain counts for nothing. And then here on top of the first back post half double crochet, we make a single crochet. That's the first of 11. This is the way how you work all the way around. Work all your stitches. In the beginning, we make here on top of the first standing single crochet a slip stitch. Then don't cut the yarn. In the next round, we use the same color. I work all my stitches all the way around. After that 4th corner, we have to create 2 more V-stitches. After that last V-stitch, we skip only 1 stitch. And that's the stitch here for the popcorn. Then in the next stitch, we create that standing single crochet. And that's in the top of the first back post half double crochet. Now here on top, work 1 slip stitch. Now here we have the start of our square. The next round with the same color. We start with a chain. Counts for nothing, it's only to high up a stitch. Now back in that same stitch where you make in the previous round, that slip stitch on top of that standing single crochet, you go back into that stitch and make 1 single crochet. This is the first single crochet of 10 on this side here. So in the next 9 stitches work also 1 single crochet, 10 in total. That's 1. Into the next stitch, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So we have here 10 single crochets on the 10 single crochets of the previous round. In the next stitch, that's on the top of the two double crochet together, you make also one single crochet. Then in the chain two single crochets in that space. That's one and two. On top of the next two double crochets together, also one single crochet. Now here in the next V-stitch, we make a new V-stitch of two double crochet together in that chain two. That's one, two, yarn over work together, make a chain two, back in that same chain two space with another two double crochet together. After that V-stitch, we skip the two trebles together and then in the chain two space we make a new V-stitch of trebles. So yarn twice over, in that chain two space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, put for two, yarn over, put for two. Yarn twice over the hook, back in that same space, make a not complete treble. Yarn over, work together. Make a chain two, back in that same chain two space here, you work also two trebles together in that same space. So you have here a V stitch of two trebles together. Now we make a corner, chain five, one, two, three, four, five. We skip over the next two trebles together. Then in the next chain two space, we make a new V-stitch of trebles together. Yarn twice over, in the next chain two space, make one not complete treble and a second not complete treble. Yarn over, work together, make a chain two, back in that same chain two space with two trebles together. We skip over the two trebles together and the two double crochet together, and then in the chain two space of that V of the double crochets together, we make a new V stitch of two double crochets together. So yarn over, in that chain two space, two double crochet together, chain two, back in that same chain two core of a chain two space with two double crochet together to work that V stitch complete in that V stitch yonder. Now we skip here the two double crochet together, and then in the next two double crochet together of the next V stitch, you work one single crochet in that stitch. Then in the chain two space, two single crochets, so one and two, and then on top of the next two double crochet together, also one single crochet. Then in the next stitch, that's on the top of the first single crochet, you work also one single crochet, and that's the first single crochet of 10 single crochets, and that's the same single crochet than the first one here in the beginning. So all these stitches that you work here, you repeat three more times. Then close here on top with the slip stitch, with a slip stitch on the top of the first single crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use also the same color. And all the way around, after that last single crochet that we work on top of the V-stitch in the second two double crochet together, we have to close with a slip stitch on top of the first single crochet. Here in the beginning we work one chain that counts for nothing. You skip that stitch, then on top of the first single crochet make one slip stitch. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round, we use the same color. With the same color, we start with the chain 3. Counts for your first double crochet. Now you work in every stitch one double crochet. Yarn over and hook into the next stitch. Double crochet into the next stitch and double crochet. Almost reach the corner. Here in that V stitch, the first two double crochet together, we work on top one double crochet. Then in that chain 2 space, two double crochets in that space. That's one and two. Then on the next two double crochet together, one double crochet on top. Now we have here two trebles together, also one double crochet on top of that stitch. In the next chain 2 space, two double crochets in that space. It's one and two. On top of the next two trebles together, make on top one double crochet. And now here in that chain 5 corner space, we make a new corner. Three double crochets in that corner. One, two, three. Make then a chain 2, one and two. Back in that same chain 5 corner space with three double crochets. One, two, and three. This is your new corner. On top of the next two trebles together, make one double crochet in that stitch. In the chain 2 space, two double crochets. One and two. In the next top of the two trebles together, make one double crochet. On the next two double crochet together, one double crochet on top of that stitch. In the next chain 2 space, two double crochets. And on top of the next two double crochet together, also one double crochet. Your corner is complete. Now work on every stitch one double crochet. This is the way how you work all the way around all these double crochets. We close here with a slip stitch on top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. I'm all the way around, making slip stitch on top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. It's 1, 2, 3 in that stitch. Cut the yarn and weave the tails in. Two more rounds to go, the darker blue is back on the hook and we start here anywhere for a corner. Doesn't matter which stitch, and we start with a standing back post half double crochet. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over. Then here for the corner, you go from behind to between two stitches. You go around that double crochet from the front to the back. Then grab your yarn and pull up. Three loops on the hook, yarn over and pull to three in one go for a back post half double crochet. Also around the next few stitches for the corner, make a back post half double crochet. So yarn over, from behind around the next stitch. On the back you grab your yarn, pull under to that stitch, yarn over and pull to three. And here, in the corner of that chain two, we make a new corner. Two half double crochets, chain two, two half double crochets in that same chain two corner space. Yarn over, enter your in that space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull to three. That's one. Back in that same space with another half double crochet. Then a chain two. And back in that same chain two corner space with two half double crochets to complete the first corner. Then around every stitch you work again a back post half double crochet, and your first is here in the corner around the first double crochet here. And around to the next stitch and the next stitch. Work like this all the way around. Around every double crochet you work one half back post, one half double crochet, and in every chain two corner space you work a new corner of two half double crochets, chain two, two half double crochets all the way around. Close here on the top with a invisible join and I show you how to work that stitch. I complete all the stitches all the way around. Now we make here in the beginning a invisible join and I show you how to work that. So we cut the yarn, not short. And then we open up that stitch. You pull your hook all the way up. Then you grab the needle. And then we make that invisible join, not on the top of the first stitch, but on the second stitch. The first stitch is here your standing back post half double crochet. This stitch here. We skip that stitch. You go to the next stitch. And then on top, under to that V here. You go from the front to the back. Then pull through. Now you go back to your last stitch. And then here, you see also that V. Only in the back loop of that V. You go in with your needle. And then you go also in the back loop of your first stitch. That's the standing half back post half double crochet. Also here that V only in the back loop of that stitch. Then you pull through. And then this stitch here is your invisible join. Also a nice V-stitch. On the back you make a little knot and weave the tails in on the back of the stitches. And then we have to go one more round and then the square is complete. So we're going to work on the final round of this square. And the light blue color for me is back on the hook with the slip knot. And we begin a few stitches for the corner, doesn't matter which one, you choose one stitch and we start with a standing back post double crochet. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, and then a few stitches for the corner. You work from behind around that back post half double crochet between two stitches. Go around that stitch, grab your yarn and pull under through that stitch, three loops on the hook. Now work one double crochet, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two. Then around the next stitches, back post double crochet, yarn over, around the next stitch, that's the stitch in the corner for me. Yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over. The last stitch here for the chain two corner space, also from behind around that stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two for back post double crochets. Now here in the chain two corner space, we make a new corner. Two half double crochets, chain two, two half double crochets in that space. Yarn over, enter you can the chain two, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull to three. Spun. Back in that same space for a second half double crochet, then make a chain two. Two more half double crochets back in that same chain two corner space for your new corner. Now around every stitch on the straight side, we work again and back post double crochet. Your first back post double crochet is here in the corner. So you yarn over, enter your hook from behind in that chain two corner space and go around that first stitch here. On the back, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull to two, yarn over, pull to two, yarn over, go around the next stitch. Yarn over, pull to two, yarn over, pull to two. Now around every back post half double crochet, you work a back post double crochet. So you work all the way around. Then in the beginning, we work again an invisible join in the beginning. That we do that on the second stitch here. And then we're done. So my square is complete. I'm all the way around, make an invisible join in the beginning and wave the tails in. And this is the end result from the big 3D popcorn flower square. This is a big square and for my choice of yarn, my square is about 26 centimeters wide. If you like this tutorial, then please thumbs up below my video. And if you haven't already to subscribe to my channel, then please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. For now, thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!